Hi, this is second video about HUSKY WooCommerce Products Filter. In this video, we will review view types of the filter elements. On the basic, we can see checkboxes, labels, dropdowns, multi-dropdowns, and of course, also radio. But question. For example, for color, we want to see color, not drop-down, radio, checkbox or something else. We want to see color. So, in this stage, we should review another view types. Directly for the product color, there is exist extension. So, let's activate it. Its name, color. Check it and save changes. Okay, next, let's select view type color for the color and save changes. Now, let's toggle color terms. So, what do we have? Black. Okay, let it be black. Color red. Let's select red. Also, make your attention here. If you know the color hex code you want to apply, you can type it here. Next, white is white. So, let's type it. And mix. What about mix? Mix if when we can apply more than one color. But here we can select only one. Yes. In this case, image will help you. Click on select image and select any image you want. For example, let's select this Great Britain flag. Okay, green is green, etc. Okay, we have all the colors and image selected. Let's press save changes. Let's go to the side front. And look, now product color looks better. Also for the color, you can in additional options select show tooltip. This is the first and classic way to make color as color. The second way is using Smart Designer. It's more advanced way, and I would recommend you use this one. So first, let's create element. Let's name it My Color. Okay, let's start edit it. Here we should select color. Okay, even just now we can back from here and select it for our color. As you can see, it has prefix SD and title of the smart element. Save changes. Let's update. Okay, as you can see, each terms has black color. How to fix this situation? Let's go back to Smart Editor, to our color, and on the same way, we should append it. You see here, but colors here are included. It's just demonstration how it will look on the side front. So, for attaching color, we should select it in this drop down, product color. Now you see, all the terms are black. Right, that's right. So now we should attach colors and images to our terms. Let's click on this button. You can select color and images for each term. So for images, select image. And for the color, select it from here I pause the video and we'll continue the same way. Just close this pop-up. As you can see now, colors are selected. Next, what you can do here in the Smart Designer, you can select border radius, for example, border widths, default color, you don't need it, it's black, border color, by default border color is blue, but you can change it to something another, border type, for example, this one or such one, margin right, margin bottom, show tooltip on hover, let's enable it. You see, tooltip is here. And selected hover returns, so let's check this one. Hover border or and another things. Also, you can change design of the counter here. Show counter or hide counter. So, if it's shown, you can select min widths, top of it, right side, text font size, text color, font family, you can type here if you know it, font weight, side padding, background color, for example, this one, or even background image, border widths, border radius, border color, type of color, border, okay, text color, let's change it to another one, to black. Okay, let's go to the structure. Already it's selected. Just save changes if we didn't it before. Let's update the page. As you can see, it's absolutely another elements here. So in such way you can create not only color elements. Let's create another checkbox elements. So back here, create new element. Name it, for example, my checkbox number one. Let's go into it. There is two templates. If you want to use checkboxes in classic way, you can leave it as here, or without no subcategories, you can select another template. No matter that it looks a little ugly, just make the size. Just now, let's select template 1. Let's back size to another size. Okay, as you can see, it's nearly done. What about counter? So let's go to the counter and make it a little bigger. On the same way, you can do it by range slider. Okay, let's leave it. Let's go to the structure, product categories, and select my checkbox. Save changes. Update the page. And now you see it's something another. Maybe it's bigger a little, but it depends on your preferences. Also, you can make bigger this text, for example, we can always back to options of my checkbox and make it bigger. Text font family, text font size. Okay, let's change it to another value. And on the same way, we can look it on the front. You see? So it works. And of course, you can change color of this checkbox. You can even select image. Let's select image. For example, this one. We selected image. Okay. But what about selected elements, but we should go to the selected hover term section and select image here. Let's select this one. Okay, I just selected hover image and select image. We can select the same one. Let's go to the side front and it works. There is only limitation in the fantasy. So you can create any element you want for your business. Okay, we created another checkboxes color. But what about product size? If you want to see another labels, how to customize it? Of course, classic way is using CSS. But what if you don't know it? How to make it more in easy way? Let's go to our smart designer. Back from here, create new element. My size, for example. Or my labels. Also, you can check twice and rename it. Go into just created element and select here template without no subcategories. Let's make size, for example, 40-40. Okay, let's make it even bigger, 60-60. Next, we can select change text color. For example, let it be red. Let's change design of counter. So, make it a little bigger. Border radius. Let's set 0. And now, position. Top. And right. Let's go back to our structure. And for product size, select my labels. Save changes. Let's go to the front and update it. Now you can see absolutely another design. And of course you can make it better than I shown in this video. Just change options and look, change and look. And you will create design you want to see. In this video I shown you how to create another view type. We reviewed classic coloring by using classic way, by activation extension color. And also we reviewed another new way to creating new view types using Smart Designer. In summary, you can see what you can create using Smart Designer on demo 2. Just enter it and look at it. So just open your fantasy and create any element you want. By the way, also Smart Designer allows to create switchers. Using this special button just created only for this demo, you can see different variations of elements. So it's just enough for this video, and see you on the next video. See you. Bye.